According to the district officials, Chikube receives 400 million shillings every quarter from the government, but they say it is not enough to run the department's errands.
We are in negotiations, of course, with the ministry through the health department to see to it that we upgrade, we try to uplift the health center force. We thank the ministry. They were able to accept a second health center 4, that's Changwali Health Center 4, to upgrade it because it was working. The services it was doing and offering were more or less at the standards of Health Center 4, but it was only the requirements, the policies, the funding that was not coming in as Health Center 4. But that was granted, so we believe that any of these two facilities,
if we are looking at having Chikube Health Center 4 related to district hospital, because apparently we don't have a district hospital. It serves as a health center for as well as a district hospital. I have high hopes in Kenneth. Yes, a lot has been.
The district's misery has been stretched further by the influx of people to the district because of oil and gas activities. Stephen Asera Itaza, the Buhanguzi East Member of Parliament, says the district has inadequate medical staff, which has also become a challenge.
We don't have the required number of staff to work in these health centers, and this is a situation that is causing issues with our health sector. But above all, we are looking at raising the ban that was put on the recruitment so that we can bridge this gap and be able to serve our people well.
These were revealed during the official handover of one ambulance given to the district by the Minister of Health.
We do appreciate so much as a department receipt of this ambulance. It will be an addition onto the two other ambulances that we have stationed at Kikube.
I really humbly ask everybody, the public, please let's utilize the services of the ambulance. Let's not leave our people sick in the homes when there's an emergency, and yet there is a free service that can be helped, that can be of help to you, that can be help to your people to save lives.
We have had the cases of people using ambulances for other things, transporting people, charcoal, matog and others. This one we cannot allow. We want it to be put into its use.
In Entebbe, residents of Chitubulu in Katavi Town Council were delighted to receive water from a borehole donated by All Nations Theological College and Seminary in conjunction with Katavi Town Council.
It is very necessary to have clean water. But now when you look at the government policy, the government requires national water in all town councils. But it is not possible. Not all people can manage national water. What we do now is to provide for facilities for those people who can't manage national water. And we've gone ahead to do that with people like Reverend Victor, who solicited money from their country.
I believe that Uganda is blessed country.
Report by Godfrey Mohomuza and Godfrey Sempija for the news.